My name is Andy Golding. I'm the housemaster of Army House. I wasn't always a teacher. By training, I'm a lawyer. Although I did an English literature degree at Nottingham University, I then switched to law. Army House is very much at the centre of the school. In fact, every pupil who comes towards Snake Door, towards the main classrooms, will pass in front of Army House. So our pupils like the fact that we're within very close reach of the football pitches on Max and Major. They also like the fact that they're within a stone's throw of the dining hall.
The thing that I like most about Army House is the fact that it's right in the centre of the Bradfield sort of area, so you can easily get to your lessons.
There are 52 boys in Army House at the moment, and that's pretty much average. Of those 52, six of them are day boys.
The boy that tends to be in the house is one that does enjoy taking part. We don't tend to have many boys who do nothing. And that may well be with sport, it may well be with drama, will be a bit of music, but generally speaking, we are competitive in all the house competitions.
Yeah, Army House is, I'd say, a talented house at sports, but I think football's our main sport.
The matron's role in Army House is to be a nurse, so she is there again at the front line to provide relatively minor health care, so paracetamol, Nurofen and that kind of thing, but to take care of aches and pains and strains after a strenuous house match, for example.
Matron is really nice. We tend to go to her for just for a chat if we need to. She's really nice and up for that the whole time. She also has a tuck shop, which is great, instead of a long walk to the junior blundles.
I just enjoy the boys more than anything else, and it's really great when there's not a lot to do, but you're just around in case they need you. And they come in groups, and we have a lot of bant, and they like that, and I like that. We have a few laughs, and that's probably the best part of the job.
Well, matron's she's always there for any issues. If you're ever feeling ill, she's always there for you.
She's like a second mum.
Yeah, she's a second mum, that's good.
So my role, really, I always feel, is to be supportive of how they feel.
So on a Friday, we go to our tutors. We have a 10-minute session. We go to his office and we talk about what we've done in the week and what we've got coming up in the week. He tells us what he thinks we should do to try and help boost our academic grades and our effort grades.
So my role as tutor, I would have one evening in the house with the boys, which is a Wednesday night. And in that evening, I would chat to the boys. I'd try and make sure I go around the house and speak to all of them individually. Might help them a little bit with their studies, with their work, but also any support they might need throughout, kind of pastorally throughout school.
Things I like most about Army House is the sport's really good. All the people are really nice. It's in a great location. And Matron and Mr. Golding are really, really nice as well.
The reason why I like my housemaster is because he's really open, so you can just go and talk to him about whatever you're worried about.
It's always really good that he's an accessible place, that you can always see him if you need to, especially during the night if you've had problems.
I would think that, I would hope that Army House is defined also by a lack of pomposity. And I would say that pupils, and particularly parents over the years, would agree with that they would feel that they can contact me pretty much instantaneously by email or by telephone and would find me quick to respond. So I feel as though I have a very good relationship with the parents of the pupils in Army House.
The house is very much in the centre of the college, and I think it plays an integral part of the college, actually. Everyone walks past Army House when they go to dinner and when they go to chapel and they go to lessons. And I think to that extent, Army House is very integral to the running of Bradfield College.